Hey everybody, different hat. Welcome back to Freedom One Garage. We are at the St. John's car show. Pretty good turnout. We had a couple cars leave, so I'm going to hurry up and make this video before more people have had their fill and go ahead and leave. But good showing of cars. We had about 15 cars total, and we've got about that many tractors. So we'll just kind of walk through. We got late model T-Bird. V8 T-Bird, by the way. Sweet little 39 Ford coupe. Racer red. Cool tan interior. Torque thrust. 1930 Ford two-door. Not two doors, Tudor. Very cool restoration on this guy. Cool blue paint over black with that yellow stripe. Very nice car. Trans Am, it's a 6.6. Nice red Firebird. Correction, Trans Am, sorry, didn't mean it. Then we got the Galaxy 500. This car is just a beautiful car with the 390 in it. 73 Mustang and green color 302 V8. Here, this one was here last year. Cool little Ram pickup. I think it's got the 5.9 in it. It's for sale. You know anybody who wants a really decked out Ram truck, four-wheel drive, short box, standard cab? Tell you what, standard cab short box is where it's at lately. Crushed velvet kind of painted interior. A lot of work into this rig. This is cool. Restored Cushman. Let's look. 1995 Cushman. Turf, it's a truckster. The bed tilts. That's cool. Two-speed transmission. You know, kind of a side-by-side before side-by-sides were cool. Of course, we've got our little showing here. We've got the Corvette 78 pace car. It's for sale, folks. 38,000 original miles. Never been painted, never been upholstered. We touched up, again, the center spoiler and the bumperettes, but otherwise this is a survivor car, 38,000 miles. Even has the vintage Eagle ST still on it. Runs and drives out wonderfully. Contact us if you're interested in this car. I've got my pride and joy, Jeep CJ7. A lot of work gone into this Jeep. It's actually on a Jeep YJ frame with the tub because it was rusty when I bought it. But six cylinder, four speed transmission swap, 430 gears, lockers front and rear, chrome molly axles, shop made, homemade bumpers front and rear, handmade trailer, painted to match the Jeep, 37s on the Jeep, 35s actually on the trailer, custom rear end with a CJ tailgate, and then we've got our shop trucks here. You guys have seen this in quite a few of our videos. 76 F-250 lowered. We just chopped the springs in the front and did an axle flip in the back. Nice truck, 390 truck, automatic. It's waiting patiently for a fuel injected 460. And I promise, ladies and gentlemen, we will get to that. But this was where we started, you know, getting customized with her body work was on this pickup truck, and we've got a lot of plans for this truck, so stay tuned to the channel for updates on this once we get a couple other things out of the way. Got a cool 51 Dodge farm truck, frame off, restored, very neat bright red. I think he had some brake issues with it yesterday, but he got some of that sorted out, so life's pretty good. Neat little farm truck. Now to the tractors. Minneapolis Mowing, the M602. Some of you mowing people will have to comment maybe on what the significance of that is. Well, hey, maybe it says here on the little info sheet. Brown belly, yellow tin work. Very cool. Four cylinder, gas powered, 65 horsepower running this big hog of a tractor. Then we've got the 302, brightly painted as well. 55 horsepower. Here's a 4 Super. Really neat little gas burner mowing here. Getting 45 horsepower out of this rig. Got the Minneapolis Mowing M5. Now this is going to be a diesel rig. Very cool. 69 horsepower. Prairie gold is what they called that color. And we got the G6. This isn't JV, not JV. It's G6. This is a number. Again, this is where we're getting up into size again. Very neat. Big diesel tractor. 425 cubes of power, and by power I mean 78 horses. But man, can you imagine the amount of torque turning? This tractor would probably pull a ton. And then we've got the 5-star. Very neat tractor. This, see that big round thing? Propane. She's a propane pusher. 4-cylinder. 283 cubic inches. No, it's not a Chevy V8. Inline 4-cylinder making 57 horsepowers. Ooh, that's cool. We got a model of the same tractor inside the catch jar. Nice. Very neat. This is one of the Freedom One Garage stable. This is our little Ferguson TO20 from 1952. I apologize. I have no idea how much horsepowers it makes. Probably 20, 18, 20, something like that. It's been a great little tractor for us. Here, look at this. Ford, I don't know if this is an 8 or a 9. Somebody comment for me. But check it. It's got a flathead Ford V8. One of the guys told me, I think it's 1937 vintage. Flathead Ford V8 open headers. I didn't hear this get unloaded and parked here, but apparently it's naughty. Yeah, very cool. Ford flatheads. Flathead swapped out acreage tractor. Oliver Row Crop 88, very cool tractor. The only Oliver here this year. Last year we had a bunch of Olivers. 1951. Now this is also gas burner. You gotta love the Oliver, how the quirky paint jobs with the reds and the yellows and the green. And here's our one and only mass. Well, we've got a Harris Ferguson. This is actually a Massey Harris. Very cool. Got the little shade canopy. Gonna need that later today. Little gas burner, 4-cylinder. Narrow front end on that one. And then we've got, this is a unique tractor. John Deere 435. This is a 2-cylinder diesel. Also 2-stroke. Diesel. Actually, GM supplied the power plant for this tractor. Really neat. Makes pretty good power. Sounds totally different than all these tractors here going down the road because it's a two-stroke diesel. But he can actually pull this 2-tooth chisel with this tractor, and it pulls it pretty easily according to him. So neat selection of cars, neat selection of tractors. And we've got some of the same stuff, but we've got quite a large number of new stuff. So that's it for the car show. Hey, mark your calendars next summer, probably first-ish weekend in July. We're going to do this again, Marquette, Nebraska, St. John's Lutheran Church, Kronberg Corner. Good food, good people. Just chilling out for a few hours. Beautiful day. So, thanks for watching. Appreciate the likes and subscribes and questions and comments. We'll catch you on the next one.